Ta-da! Hi there, folks. Thanks for clicking onto my channel today. This is Cooking with Sasha China, and today I'm going to show you how I do my version of macaroni cheese. Good old mac and cheese, can't go wrong with that at all. So the first thing that you're going to need is obviously some cheese. Main thing, bring your cheese up to room temperature first, that way it's just going to melt so much easier. So on the plate here, we've got some Gouda cheese, some mozzarella. Try and stay away from the pre-shredded ones, but obviously mozzarella you can't really say, well you can, can't. Anyway, mozzarella. We've got some mature cheddar, some red Leicester, some Edam cheese, and also some Gruyere cheese. Lots of cheese there. Also, you're gonna need some milk. So this is kind of contradicting itself really bad, so I've got the lactose-free milk, because I'm actually lactose intolerant, but let's not talk about that. Woohoo! Cheese, milk. You're gonna need some butter, some flour, some breadcrumbs for the topping. You don't have to do this if you don't want to. I've got some plain breadcrumbs and some golden breadcrumbs in there as well. You're gonna need your macaroni. You can either use the elbow one, the straight one like this, or penne pasta, any kind of pasta, it's fine. In here, I've zhushed it up. I've got some black pepper, some ground black pepper, some paprika, onion powder, garlic powder, and also a touch of what else have I got in there? Bit of parsley as well. I've also got some bacon lardons because I'm also going to fry those off, mix it into the mac and cheese, so adds a bit of moot to it. So flat leaf parsley just to chop up and pop on the top. So first thing, get your cheese up to room temperature, chop it up how you want to have it prepared, get your flour out and all your other condiments ready. Now what we're going to do, we're going to boil off the macaroni. You're not going to want to cook it fully, make it still quite al dente, because with this recipe you can bake it as well. If you want to bake it, then don't cook it fully, it will finish off in the oven. Preheat your oven, by the way, mine's on 200. Oh, sorry, I'm not paying attention. So first thing we're going to do now, I've just said it, is preheat your oven, cook off your macaroni, and then we're going to make the roux. So to make your roux, first thing you're going to need to do is obviously melt some butter in a pan. Once that's nicely melted down, you're going to add in your flour. Once you've added in your flour, you kind of want like a pastry consistency. So kind of a bit of a pastry consistency, there we go. And then you're going to want to add in your milk. And one thing you need to do is whisk, 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 whisk. Don't stop whisking because you do not want like your undercooked flour in there. It's going to taste anything but nice. So yeah, whisk, and then once you've done that, you're then going to add in your cheese, which is making your cheese sauce. You're going to add in your dry seasonings here. All right, so we'll get to that point, then we'll come back. Pasta in. Butter melting, now add flour. Now to add the milk. Just keep whisking. Now add in the pepper and the cheeses. Cheese sauce made. Pasta ready. Now time to fry off the lardons. Bacon fried off. Now time to put everything together. Cheese at the bottom. Alrighty, the macaroni and the cheese sauce have been mixed together with the lardon bits. Now time to add in the toppings. So with the plain breadcrumbs and the golden breadcrumbs, what you're going to want to do is melt some butter, mix it into here, and then place it on top. So once you put the melted butter into the breadcrumbs, just give it a nice mix around so it becomes a nice crumbly texture. Sprinkle some parsley on top. Now time for the breadcrumbs. Alrighty, and we are done. So now time to pop it in the oven. Bear in mind that this pasta is al dente, so you do need to put it in the oven. But if you have cooked the pasta fully, then obviously you can eat it straight away. So the breadcrumbs on, and now we're going to add in a little bit more of the parsley, and that is ready to go into the oven. Alrighty, and we are ready, folks. So I've just finished it off with some fresh parsley chopped on top. And here we go. This was my version of mac and cheese. Thanks for watching, guys. This was Cooking with Sasha China. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye now.